Well, I got to learn a couple things today. This video could be called, when you get an NA from VLOOKUP, how to triage that character by character. It could also be called, VLOOKUP fails due to a strange hyphen. Or, when the Excel code function returns 63, that's a sign that you might need to use the Unicode function instead. All right, today's question from Michelle. Now, she sent a much bigger file, but none of her VLOOKUPs are working, and Michelle already knew how to use trim and clean, and it still fails. All right, so anytime that this happens, I'm like, oh, send me the file. All right, and I go through these steps. I know that I'm trying to figure out why 088619-000 is not matching 088619-000. And I always go through these steps right here. I want to know the length of both of these. Is there some hidden character there? So equal LEN of what's above us. That one has 10. This one has 10. Okay, so same length. Over here, I'm going to put the numbers 1 to 10. I'll use the sequence function for that. You could do it. You could just type the numbers, whatever you want to do. And we're going to look at this character by character. So equal mid of this text. I'm going to press F4 1, 2 times to lock it down to row 15. Where do I want to start? I want to start at the 1 in A17. This time I'll press F4 3 times to lock the columns down. And I want exactly one character. Double click to copy that down. And then I should be able to copy that over here. And everything, of course, at this point is going to look the same. But it doesn't matter how it looks, right? Because behind the scenes, you know, going back to the early days of computing, there was something called the ASCII character set. Originally, it was 127 characters. I guess zero may have been one of them, probably 128 characters. And in Excel, we can use the code and character function. So if you have a number, like here, let's just take 65 is a capital letter A, so equal CHAR of 65 will give you the letter A, or on the flip side, you can use equal code of that A to find out that the A is a character 65. All right, so here we're going to use equal code to figure out what number is actually stored there, right? And that says it's a 48, and that makes sense. You know, I haven't memorized the ASCII character codes, but I generally know that 65 is a capital letter A, somewhere up in the 90s is a lowercase a, 48 is a zero, and then the punctuation is like 32 to 47. There's some more punctuation here, some more punctuation here, right? So that when I see that 48, you know, that seems to make sense to me. Double click and copy it down, all of those look good. And then over here, I'm gonna do the exact same thing and look at these codes, right? And then I wanna just do a little check and see, does this code match that code and copy it down. Check this out. Okay, so there's our problem. On the left, the number we're looking up, it has a hyphen that's a ASCII code 45. And on the right, the lookup table that we got from the vendor has an ASCII code 63. Now that doesn't make sense to me. Like why? Like this, I'd have to go look it up, but the 45 generally seems right. 63 shouldn't be a hyphen. And when I go look, sure enough, 63 is a question mark, right? And then that just doesn't match. Like, why? What's going on here? The explanation is in an alternate character set called Unicode. Well, ASCII originally had 127 characters, then later 256 characters. Unicode today has 149,186 characters. Like, every symbol in every language. Lots of emojis, formatting codes, all kinds of stuff is here, and it's maintained by the Unicode Consortium. I remember reading maybe 5 years ago that a group of people had asked for the Klingon characters to be made part of Unicode, and the Unicode Consortium refused because it wasn't a real language. Right? So there's some board out here deciding whether or not to add characters. So while Excel has the code and character function to deal with ASCII, they've added the Unicode and UNICHAR function to deal with codes that are Unicodes, right? So this table that I've been using my whole life to try and figure out these VLOOKUP problems, we now need to add an extra column to this table to check for the Unicode, right? So here I'm going to ask for the equal Unicode of that character. And here, they all exactly match ASCII, but here, I'll insert a column for Unicode, copy that over, we find out that this hyphen in the vendor part number is not a character 45 hyphen. It is a character 8208 from Unicode. What the hell? Well, doing a little bit of research here, jcorpella.fi has a list of 28 different dashes in Unicode. And sure enough, 8208 is just a regular old hyphen. Why did the vendor decide they had to use this one instead of a character 45? Like, do they have other hyphens in their part numbers that are something different? That is a great mystery. So the solution for Michelle is to use equal substitute of, in this text, we're going to look for Unicare 8208 and replace that with care 45. Oh, that's silly. We could actually have this on our keyboard. Let's put in quotes a regular old hyphen like that. Copy that down. Control C, come over here and paste as values. Control Shift V, and our VLOOKUP start to work. Although that one, I have the wrong item from the table. All right, my bad on that. And really, there should be a fourth title to this video about why does the clean function not kept up with the times. So here's all the ASCII characters from 0 to 255. There's the character. And then does clean get rid of that character? Ideally, you want to have a length of 0 if clean works on it. So data, filter, let's look at all the ones that are zeros. All right, so it's cleaning these unprintable characters below 32. It cleans 129, 141, 143, 144, 157. Doesn't do anything with a non-breaking space at 160. That causes a lot of VLOOKUPs to fail. There's a lot of strange characters that don't get cleaned. And I want to do the same thing with Unicode. So here's sequence of 149,000. There's the Unicare. And then the length of the clean. Let's take a look at this and see if they're cleaning any of those Unicode characters. Okay. Look for the zeros. So it's cleaning Unicode 1 through 31. And then it's smart enough to clean Unicode 128 to 159. Then it looks like they just gave up after that. So clean definitely is not handling the majority of the Unicode. It just brings up so many questions. Why is this vendor using Unicare 8208 for the dashes? Should Excel VLOOKUP see a character 32 and character 160 as a match? Should it see a character 45 and Unicare 8208 as a match? And then the code function. So the code function encounters Unicode, and the developer who wrote the code for code says, oh, we're going to return a question mark. But instead of actually returning a question mark, it returns the ASCII code of a question mark, which is just too freaking subtle for me. Shouldn't it return a value error or something to let you know, hey, you're trying to get the ASCII code for this, and it's not ASCII. Hey, program note, this might be our 2500 episode. When I started, I was back in the Tech TV days, and episode 101 was season 1, episode 1, so the Mr. Excel podcast, it debuted at episode 101. Which makes this episode 2600 our 2500th episode. And it's something as boring as a Unicode hyphen. That's the way it happens. But then I started thinking about it. There was at least 12 emergency episodes inserted between pre-recorded episodes and 37 shorts that weren't numbered. So, I don't know. Maybe it was episode 2551 was the anniversary. Yeah, hard to say. Anyway, thanks to all of you who hang around and watch these. I really appreciate it. Well, yeah, I want to thank Michelle for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.